Let's go if you want. Back your corner.
Leone against Okazaki is brought to you by Fairtex. Be inspired. Meltan signaling the start of the contest. America against
right,
Japan.
Back.
Right, very high-level grappler,
judge
Leone.
Time. Ready?
Through back, that back, American back, wrestling back, system. Back. Oh, and a false start. Nice. Olivier right, Cost not happy
ready,
at all with that. Where we go.
Leone's been out of the cage for a while now, so he is really excited to get back in there. He's got a tough opponent here tonight against Okazaki. Leone immediately shoots in for the takedown, slides right back up to body control.
Very fast movement between the takedown and then sliding up, wasn't it?
It's just high-level wrestling right there. He immediately transitioned to something else. That chain wrestling where they just go from one thing to another. You know, and we've seen in the past fights of Okazaki, he has a harder time with the wrestlers. You know, he gets put on the ground and held there, and that's Andrew's strength. So this is a really good stylistic matchup for both our combatants tonight.
Yeah, it could be a long one, this one. A very technical fight that you can really get absorbed by.
Nice takedown by Leone as he ends up on top there. He's in the half guard of Okazaki.
Japanese man just pulling him in, although he's released that now. And now it's up to Leone to dictate the distance between the two of them.
See, that's what Leone wants to do. He wants to flatten Okazaki down onto the mat, start utilizing some ground and pound. Okazaki, on the other hand, wants to slide off to his side and start creating space. But these Japanese grapplers are so creative and unorthodox in all their positions that you never really know what they're going to be doing next.
Watch how Leone uses his head sometimes just to move his opponent's head to the side, just to gain a little bit of advantage in position. Just not headbutting him, but just nudging his head along. Uses every available bit of his body to improve his position.
You can see Leone's trying to slide that leg out. He's trapped in half guard, which means Okazaki has one leg wrapped up with both his legs of Leone. There's a few submissions from this position, but it's hard when you're flattened out onto the back where both your shoulders are flat onto the mat. He's got full guard again, so both his legs are on the outside of Leone's body.
Okazaki may well have to get used to spending a lot of this fight on his back. Meanwhile, he has a cut to deal with. Looks as if it's around the bridge of the nose or around the left eye.
That was a beautiful step over guard pass of Andrew Leone. How he just hopped out of the butterfly guard of Okazaki and landed in side control. Now he goes into the mount. This is some high level grappling by Leone. Now you can see Okazaki's cutting out one leg.
The right arm was just under quite a bit of pressure there from Leone. He gave up on it in the end. And the blood is getting into Okazaki's eyes, and that's the real problem. On his back, as he bleeds from above his eye there, it'll block his vision entirely. It's one thing when you're standing up, it's another when you've got your back to the canvas. Really struggling to see there. You can see him grimacing, blinking hard.
But you gotta think, when you're on the ground, you don't need to see as well. You know, because you're on the ground, you can just feel your opponent and know what he's doing. Great, it's not the best advantage to have, but it's gotta be better than standing up and having all those punches, kicks, elbows, and knees coming at you.
Right elbow, right elbow, all day! Stay busy with that right elbow!
1 minute and 15 left of this first round.
Leone's really applying lots of shoulder pressure. He's really controlling this position well. He's using underhooks and overhooks, meaning he's taking his arms and kind of placing them in more advantageous positions to keep Okazaki flat onto the mat and not able to initiate any kind of defense or create space.
Meanwhile, that right forearm continues to do damage around the bridge of the nose, the one that's already injured. For us to see at the end of this round exactly where that cut is.
We've seen some of the past fights of Okazaki where he's actually been, you know, controlled in a lot of these fights, but then he's come back to stop the fight out of nowhere. Now, Leone could be looking for a possible cure. He's kind of just holding the position, waiting possibly for the round to be over.
Elbow to the back of the head is an illegal blow, and Olivier Coste was straight on that.
There's a mounted position from Leone. Okazaki creating a scramble a bit. There's a possible choke. Lots of movement from these two to create new positions and really transition to another better possible submission. But when you move these submissions, when you move in these positions, you leave yourself open to these possible submissions. But good first round and control by Andrew Leone.
Very quick thinking and very quick body movement. Just take us through some of these highlights, Mitch.
See, there's that, you know, nice little slides, double leg takedown, where this kind of just started this sort of ground attack from Leone. He's really controlling this fight. He's able to control these ground positions and really just kind of stop any potential movement from Okazaki.
Reed always seems very, very controlled and sort of even-spirited, Leone. And there's that cut. It is indeed on the bridge of the nose. A very strange cut indeed. I think he must have taken a very sharp, perhaps a knuckle to the nose. It must have then swelled up very quickly and then punctured itself, because you can see the swelling. Very odd place to get cut. Have you seen anything like that before, Mitch?
It looked like a hole of some kind right in the bridge of his nose.
There it is.
Could have been possible from a head, but you're right, it could. I mean, that kind of is the shape of a knuckle, Steve.
What that means is that while they're standing up, blood into the eye won't be an issue. But as we said, on his back, it will be. But as Mitch quite rightly pointed out, not so important to see what you're doing in that position because you feel your way through.
Leone immediately dives for the takedown. And Okazaki's kind of ending up on top. Beautiful scrambles by Leone as he's able to possibly take the back here. He's got both hooks in now. This is a bad position for Okazaki, but he gets out of it. You can see Andrew trying to go for that double leg sacrifice throw there, kind of where Okazaki ends up on the bottom position again in half guard. Those punches, you can see him just kind of tapping the back of his head. It's really not going to do very much. It's more annoying than anything. You can just see how much it's like distance Okazaki needs to have, but Leone has given him nothing. He's just smothering Okazaki, not allowing him any space to move or create any sort of offense or potential attacking defense.
Olivier Coste looking for action. There are punches being thrown. They're not particularly heavy blows, as you point out, Mitch.
When you're on the bottom, the secret is to create space. You want to be pushing away from your opponent to create movement and to get your guard back. But when you're on top, you want to smother your opponent, especially when you're a wrestler like Leone. You don't want to allow them any space to move or create any kind of distance.
Leone certainly favors the forearm, doesn't he, as he beats down on Okazaki's head.
You can just see the space. He's just not allowing any space. So the forearm's really the only shot that he can, you know, really land on Okazaki is that short forearm.
His right leg all locked up by the Japanese man.
You can see Leone trying to use the opposite leg to slide it out, and he's creating a little bit of move there, but what he'll do is he'll push on the legs of Okazaki with his left leg to pop his right leg out. And it gives him more of a mounted type position, which he's kind of got right there.
Again, Leone using his head just to pin the opponent's head down. See how he does that with his chin?
Well, he's able to control the shin with his right shoulder, and he's kind of able to crank him into the opposite position. It really limits any movement that Okazaki can have. But there he goes, he lets go of it, and Okazaki ends up on top.
And appreciated by the crowd here in Jakarta. Applause rippling around this arena. The Astora Senayan.
Now, Andrew's in half guard. Let's see what kind of attack he can do off of his back, or what kind of punishment Okazaki can deliver from the top position.
This is not the way it's been in this fight so far, so something new for us as we enter the final 2 minutes of the second round. Leone looks wide-eyed across at his corner. See if he can pick up some advice.
Andrew Leone has his brother, Anthony Leone, in his corner, who he's just kind of listening to give any sort of advice. I'm just trying to see he's trying to keep Okazaki close to limit that distance and that space. He doesn't want to get hit. You think he can try to push away and create more space. There he goes back to guard now.
No sign is there that injury to Okazaki's nose is causing him any trouble in this round.
Our cutmen do a wonderful job of keeping safety our number one priority and really just stopping that potential bleeding that could come from those cuts.
A fight televised in over 75 countries around the world. Leone against Okazaki. 1:10 left in this second round. Punches from Okazaki get quite a reaction from the crowd here in Jakarta, left and right, and Leone's in a little bit of trouble. He's going to have to move to avoid those. When the distance opens up, the punches can be heavy. They've been so close to each other physically in this fight so far that once there's a bit of a gap, the punches can come in harder and quicker form.
We've seen this before from Okazaki. He'll spend some time on the ground and just kind of tire out his opponents, like he's almost baiting them in to making a mistake. And you can just see from right there, that onslaught of the ground and pound where Okazaki was able to land, but Leone's trying to reverse it now. Good defense by Okazaki as they end this second round, on their feet.
Applause again at the takedown from Leone. 20 seconds left. Didn't quite work out for him.
He's got to watch the back of the head there with those shots. You can see Leone is just going back to his bread and butter, that double leg takedown, trying to suck that single leg back in.
He's been warned twice about shots to the back of the head. Okazaki must be careful. A yellow card beckons if he keeps going. I love the nonchalant way Leone goes about his business, even when he's in the mix.
He comes out just kind of shaking his head. That wasn't the best way to finish that round, but he's really showing a high level of grappling. But Okazaki is also starting to come on strong now. Here's that ground and pound. Some of those shots from the guard. Those are some big shots. There's a lot of them we're missing, but a few in the beginning landed quite well. Leone's got to try to mix it up. I wonder if he's going to choose to stay on his feet. What kind of advice is his corner giving him to change the trajectory of this contest?
Towel pressed hard against that injury on the bridge of the nose. I think he's bleeding from within the nose as well, so there's obvious trouble there for Okazaki to deal with in the final 5 minutes of this contest.
This fight has been very close in the first 10 minutes. And if it was to stop now, I don't know, man. It's so close, Steve. Like the ground and pound there from Okazaki might not be enough to stop that control and the takedowns that Leone got earlier in the contest.
Caught the eye, though, didn't it? Those big punches. The first time, really, the punches had been thrown with some distance between them. And that advantage went to the Japanese man.
Leone's trying to change levels.
Went for the spinning back fist that didn't come through. Not sure what he's up to there. Those big sapphire colored eyes grinning at Okazaki.
So now he's starting to change it up. Now he's starting to strike a little bit. And now he's starting to add a different element to that game. And let's see who can actually come out on top when they start throwing hands.
I think what we can say is that Andrew's enjoying himself. He loves a battle.
Nice little knee on the entry there from Okazaki.
Good work with the hands, and Andrew has to dip down and try for the takedown. Okazaki very useful with that two-fisted attack. He gets through the guard. Penetrative punches.
Leone really likes to set up other takedowns, the clinch attempts where he shoots in for that double leg and then just slides back up to the clinch. The most entertaining aspect of this fight has been this little stand-up exchange.
Oh, very nice left jab.
Nice jab by Leone, but Okazaki landed with a counter left hand there.
I'd like to see a little bit more of this stand-up. It's intriguing, isn't it?
I like the animation that Leone's kind of shown. He seems like he's definitely, like you said, enjoying this this contest and this tough, grinding fight that he's involved with right now.
shit, hang on, look around.
Just over 3 minutes left of this third and final round. Tricky one to score.
And it looks like he could be taking the back. Now he's got a possible body triangle. You see how he blocked that left leg underneath the right leg? That just limits all movement from Okazaki. You really can't go anywhere. It's really constricting on your breathing, too.
These over-the-shoulder punches, very accurately. He's actually throwing them blind, of course, landing the punches behind his own head. As Okazaki continues to bleed from within the nose. Could well be broken, that nose.
Okazaki went five full rounds with our champion, Viviano Fernandez, to lose this decision, but we saw the submission defense from Okazaki. So Andrew has got a tough task ahead of him, even though he's got such a dominant position in the back mount here with that body triangle.
And those back punches are getting through, all of them. Close to 100%, if not 100%.
Let's go, work the finish.
We got 2 minutes left in this round, and this is a hard position to be in for Okazaki. He's really got to try to create some movement. Punching from the back like that is not going to win this fight.
I tell you, Olivier Costa is considering standing them up. He's asking for them to work to finish.
But he is working. Andrew Leone is working. He's trying to deliver some kind of punches just to open up a possible submission. If he punches him and his hands go out or his chin comes up, he can slide one of those arms underneath and sink in a choke. See? Just like that. Now his arm's under there, but Okazaki is defending so well.
And maybe even getting the better of the exchanges in terms of the fists.
See, there it is. It's underneath. This is a big right there. Now it's close. That's deep. Oh, but he fights it off. That's just grinding it out. He's got a minute 10.
He's got one arm. The other arm is still there around the throat.
That's pretty deep, though. He's got that right under the chin.
Not sure he's really pulling it that hard, though. I think if he... Yeah. Wasn't really putting his biggest effort into closing that arm around the throat once the other arm was nullified by Okazaki.
Now he's got the mount. He's got about 35 seconds here to unleash maybe some ground and pound.
Final round, so the action's all got to be done now in the next half minute.
Transitions right to the back. That has really been the story of this match, Steve. Just the ground control of Andrew Leone. He really has been showing up, really putting on a clinic for ground control.
Looks like this one's going to the judges then. You'll hear the tap. There it is, 10 seconds left. The judges will be totting up their scorecards. And I suspect it'll go the way of the American. What do you think, Mitch?
Yeah, I definitely got to give the nod to Andrew Leone. He put on a wrestling clinic. So for all you fighters out there, that is how you wrestle. You can see right there, he gets that back mount, sinks in the body triangle, and really just limits Okazaki from moving anywhere. And he just absolutely controlled at least this third round. There was that point in the second round where Okazaki unleashed a little bit of ground and pound, but the match pretty much went unanimously to Andrew Leone.
There's Beltan with the gong that she's gonna put round somebody's neck.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all three judges see it for your winner via unanimous decision, Andrew Leone!
There it is, the American takes it, improves his record to 8-2. Koetsu Okazaki, who's really been in there with the very best, will come again, I'm sure. But for this man, a title shot may not be too far away.